One main thing you should understand from these sutras, thousands and thousands of years ago when the Upanishads are written, at that time itself our people's brain has reached such a peak. Actually the scientists who work on the brain, you know, who do research on the neurological system, they say only last 1,000 years human being has developed their brain to the level in which today we see. And thousands, 1 or 2,000 years ago, it was much less. But if you see our master's logic, the rishi's logic, even in the early time, thousands of years ago, their logic is so well cultured and well developed. That is what's surprising. That is what is shocking. He knows it, who knows it not. And he knows it not, who knows it. To the man of true knowledge, it is unknown. While the ignorant, it is unknown. While to the ignorant, it is known. Indeed, he attains immortality, who realizes it in and through every bodh, every pulsation of knowledge and awareness. Through the Atman, he obtains strength and vigor, and through its knowledge, immortality. Today morning there was a discussion in the bus. Vivekananda was asking me, Swamiji, these Vedantis, they say only knowledge is more than enough, not experience is not necessary. This sutra answers for it. Through the Atman he obtains strength and vigor. You understand? It is not simply knowledge. Through the Atman he obtains strength and vigor. It means what? It is a practical purpose. The knowledge of self or the enlightenment has got a practical purpose. Down to earth, practical purpose. He obtains strength and vigor, and through its knowledge, immortality. Who realizes it here in this world, there is a true life. For one who does not so realize it, great is the loss. Discovering Atman in every single being, the wise ones, dying to this world of sense experience, became immortal. When you see Atman in every single being, you die to this world. You start experiencing the immortality. As long as you think everybody is different, you live in this world. The moment you understand, you discover Atman in every single being. That's why in NSP, the last energy session, I tell every one of you are divine. Go around and see in everybody God. I never tell you, imagine or visualize. See God in everybody. Go around and give your respect. The idea, the concept is based on this sutra only. The wise ones, dying to this world of sense experience and became immortal. Discovering Atman in every single being, the wise ones dying to this world of sense experience become immortal. When you see Atman in every being, you forget male, female, age, sex, all the other differences. You die to this world. Can a normal man touch the feet of a much younger person and much social status person normally? The NSP, you can see the person who is practically has no social status, who is much younger, who is uneducated, even he receives namaskar from highly intellect or well placed, rich, elderly person. People forget. When you discover Atman in every single being, you die to this world. Whatever discriminations are made in this world, ordinary world, you die to this world experiences, sense experiences, and you become immortal. Whatever the Upanishad Rishi speak, if you understand well, you will understand the whole thing is told in the ASP and NSP in a different way. It has been made as a practical experience for all of you. If you all go for Upanishad classes, you will really get bored because everything is known as experience. The story goes here. Next comes a beautiful story of Skanda Upanishad. Every Upanishad carries a small story. In every Upanishad there is a small story. Only Isavasya Upanishad does not have any story. The Skanda Upanishad story. Let me explain this story. The story goes that Brahman obtained a victory for the Devatas. Though the victory was due to the Brahman, the Devas were elated by it and thought, this victory is due only to us. This glory belongs only to us. These Devatas, actually Devatas again and again fall into ego. Because God supports the divine, Brahman supports them. They again and again think they are qualified. That's a big problem. When the divine helps us, when the divine supports us, we take divine for granted. A small story. It seems once there was three asuras. They are called Muppura asuras, Tripura asura, three rakshasas, three demons. They have started torturing the devatas. All these devatas wants to destroy the demons. They went and requested Shiva. Shiva told, all right, let us all go there. I will take care of him. So all the devatas have become chariot. Four Vedas have become four wheel. And Brahma has become a charioteer. So all the devatas, they handed over all their weapons to Shiva. Vishnu handed over his conch and the chakra. Durga handed over the trishul. All the devatas, they became one with the chariot energy. And then they started towards the fight. Suddenly this Indra, the egoistic guy, he thought, hey, what this Shiva? Because all of us are here, he could destroy this, he could go and fight with this demon. How can he fight without all our help? The moment Indra thought in this way, just Shiva smiled at him and raised his head and opened his third eye. The all Tripurasuras got destroyed. The place where he is sitting, from that place itself, he destroyed. The same story is described in a different way. The story means, God does not need any of your help, any of the Devatas' help, to destroy the demons. In the ashram, I used to tell this story. Sometimes our ashramites used to think, oh, because all of us are here, Swami is able to do so much of work. So I used to tell them, never think, because you are all here, the work is happening. Without any of you, the work will go on. The whole thing will go ahead. Whole thing will happen. Let you understand this story. Once, because of a victory, Devatas all started thinking that we only have won. Brahman, the god, came to know about this, their vanity. He verily appeared before them in the form of a yaksha. Yaksha means a demigod. Like yaksha, he appeared. All the devatas called for a meeting and told Agni, oh Agni, go and see who is this person. Oh Jataveda, Jataveda means Agni. Please find out who is this yaksha is. Said Agni, Agni said yes. And Agni ran to that yaksha and said, oh yaksha, who you are? Yaksha asked, who you are? Agni replied, I am verily Agni. I am known as Jadaveta. Yaksha asked, what is the power you possess? Agni says, I can burn everything, whatever is there on this earth. Then yaksha placed a small straw in front of Agni and asked Agni to burn. Agni came with all his speed, but somehow he was not able to burn. He failed and went back. Then they said, Vayu, oh Vayu, go and find out who this yaksha is. Yaksha came to the Vayu. Yaksha asked the Vayu, who you are? And Vayu says, I am the Vayu. I am also known as Matarishwa, the carrier of the atmosphere. Matarishwa means carrier of the atmosphere. Yaksha asked, what is the energy you possess? Vayu said, I can blow away everything, whatever there on the earth. Yaksha put a small straw and said, blow this straw away. Again, the Vayu tried his best, but could not throw the, could not blow the straw and went back. Then came Indra. Yaksha asked, "Who are you?" Indra said, "I am the Indra. I have come here to catch you." The Yaksha simply disappeared from the eyes of the Indra. Yaksha disappeared from his view, and in that very spot appeared a woman called Uma Devi. Uma, the daughter of the snow-clad mountain Himavat, the daughter of the Himalayas. And immediately Indra recognized her and asked, "Uma Devi, you came here. Please explain to me who is the Yaksha is. Who is this Yaksha?" The Uma explains, "The Yaksha is nothing but the god Brahman, Shiva himself. So, it is because of his energy you achieved the victory. It is because of him you are victorious. Indeed, you achieved this glory. It is from him, from the words of the Uma, Indra understood that the Yaksha was Brahman. It was from that verily these gods Agni, Vayu and Indra excel all other gods, for they approach the Yaksha nearest." Actually, the whole sutra, the whole part of this Upanishad is directed towards condemning the Karmakanda. It was the time, in those times, the Karmakanda was more popular. They were continuously giving Agudis on the Agni, Om Vayave Swaha, Om Agnaye Swaha, Om Indraya Swaha. Continuous Agudis are given. Continuous sacrifices are done. Continuous puja is done. So, Rishis wants to tell the truth to the people. These devatas are not the ultimate one. Ultimate one is the Brahman or the energy. Divine. You can say existence, the formless God. So they wanted the people to be directed towards the formless energy instead of worshipping the ordinary forms. That is the reason for this whole story. Brahman is well known by the name Tatvanam. So is to be meditated upon Tatvanam. It is the same thing as Buddha says, Tathata. All beings love him who know Brahman as such. Teach me the Upanishad. The Upanishad has been imparted to you. We have verily imparted to you the Upanishad relating to Brahman. Of the Upanishad, tapas, dhamma and karma form the support. The Vedas are its limbs and truth its abode. One who realizes it, the knowledge of Brahman, thus destroys sin and is well established in Brahman, the infinite, the blissful and the highest. In this sutra, they give the gist of the whole Upanishad. Actually, this is the sutra. They give the whole gist from the first line to last line. Let you understand the Tathata. Tathata means the suchness. Whatever is this moment is Brahman. Whatever is, all your mind, all your body, all your being, whatever you perceive through the body, mind and the intellect and your being, the whole thing is called Tathata. Tathata means suchness, the easiness. Whatever he is God. So understand whatever is God through tapas, through dhamma and through karma. They give a three technique. Tapas means austerity. Dhamma means self-restraint, controlling yourself. Karma means dedicated work, the selfless service. Use these three things and understand, realize the knowledge of Brahman. The whole thing is divine, thus destroy sin and be well established in Brahman, the infinite, the blissful and the highest. The last line.
Can I ask a question here? You said Dhamma is controlling the self.
Self, my yes.
Controlling. How is it different from separation?
Here is a beautiful question. How Dhamma, self-controlling, is different from suppression? Understand two things. Suppression means whenever the desires raise, you suppress it. Dhamma means you slip out of it. Suppression means you have a desire. You have, for example, you have a desire to eat some sweet, but you suppress it. That is called suppression. Dhamma means you have a desire to eat. You witness it. You don't suppress it. You separate yourself from the desire. You witness it. When you witness, automatically desire falls down and tumbles down and dies. You understand what I say?
Yes.
Self-restraint means you restrain yourself from getting attached itself with the senses. Whenever any desire raises, you witness it. Then you never suppress. Automatically it dies. If you suppress, you can never suppress. I tell you, if you suppress, you can never suppress. How long you can suppress? If you suppress, you will be sitting on a volcano. Any moment, it will erupt. You can never suppress. Suppressing is not self-restraint. Self-restraint means you just start witnessing. You never associate yourself with the tongue at all. You witness. So naturally the desire disappears. Dhamma is not suppression. You are able to understand?
Yes.
So the last statement is blessing from the masters. Thus destroy sins, sin and is well established in Brahman, the infinite, the blissful and the highest. Let me repeat the slokas. Om Keneshitam Padati Preshitam Manaha Kena Pranaha Pratama Praiti Yuktaha Keneshitam Vasamimam Vadanti Chakshusrotram Kavudevo Yunakti Srotrasya Srotram Manasomanoyat Vachoha Vasam Savu Pranasya Pranaha Chakshu Chakshuhu Radimushya Dhiraha Pretya Smallogatam Rutapavanti Natatra Chakshur Gacchati Navak Gacchati No Manaha Navitmo Navijanimo Yadai Danusishyat Anya Deva Tatvidita Dadoto Abidi Dadati Iti Shushruma Purvesham Yenastatya Chakshire Yat Vasanapyuditam Yena Vagapyuktyade Tadeva Brahmatvam Vidinetam Yatitamupasade Yan Manasanamanute Yena Hurmanomatam Tadeva Brahmatvam Vittinetam yatitamupasate yachakshusha napashyati yena chakshum shivashyati tadeva brahmatvam vittinetam yatitamupasate yachrotrena nasrunoti yena srotramidam srutam tadeva brahmatvam vittinetam yatitamupasate Yat pranena na praniti, yena prana praniyate, tadeva brahmatvam vitti, nedam yaditam upasate. Yati manyase, suvedeti, dapramevabi, nunam tvam, vetta brahmano rupam, yadasyatvam, yadasya deveshtita. No, Mimam Semeva Devanyeviditam Naham Manya Suvedeti Nona Vedeti वेदच नो नस्तत्वेत तत्वेत नोन वेदेति वेदच यस्या मतं तस्य मतं मतं यस्य न वेदस अविज्ञातं विजानतं विज्ञातं विजानतं प्रतिबोधविदितं मतं अमृतत्वं हि विन्ददे आत्मनो विन्ददे वीर्यं विद्यया विन्ददे अमृतम्।